Hello traders, today is the 10th of November 2010 and a happy trading to you all. This is about risk management, okay? Because there was one of our TSTW24 trader, one of the best TSTW24 traders right now creaming the market consistently, sent me an email a few weeks ago urging me to talk about the risk management or a trade management, okay? And it's a very important subject for every trader, okay? Apart from your trading tool or your timing, the second thing that you need to pay attention to is how you manage your trade and how you control the risk or how you manage the risk, okay? Because anytime you enter a trade, okay, there is an element of risk in the trade, okay? Whether it's a high probability trade, when we're talking about high probability trade, we talk about 80% of chances that the trade will be successful, or 90% of chances that the trade will be successful, which means you have at least 10% of risk that that trade may not be successful, okay? Because of different things happening in the market and different movement in the market. That's why I'll always talk about the timing of the trade, very important. But now, how do we control the risk? Now, one of the things that I learned at an early stage that saved me a lot of trouble is that you must only use 5% of your trading account, okay? Very, very important. So if you have account of $10,000, okay, the maximum that you can use is $500, okay, 5% of your trading account. So if you open, okay, you come into the market in the morning after London open, you open 5 trade or 7 trade, those 7 trade must not exceed 5% of your trading account. So anytime you have any position open, whether you have a 12 position open, whether you have 5 positions open, the total sum that you are risking on those 5 trades must not exceed 5% of your trading account. This is so important. And I find that so easy that if anything happens, suppose I open 5 trades, okay, and for one reason or another, all those 5 trades become a losing trade, my account can never be wiped out. The only thing that can be wiped out will be 5% of my trading account. That's it. So with that rule, I'm very strict about it, because I learned this from FXCM people. They were lovely people. I pick up that and I say, that's excellent. So with that, every time I come and open 3 trade, 5 trade, I know the 5% of my trading account, okay? I know exactly that. So I open the account, I never go over 5% of my trading account. And then if you manage to control that habit, okay, work with that all the time, it will be very, very difficult to wipe out your account, okay? So you need to wipe, if you want to wipe out your account trading with 5%, okay, you need to trade 20 times, okay? 20 times before your account will be wiped out. I think it's a very excellent tool to consider if you want to control the risk in the market. Another thing I want to mention also for those who are using a leverage, okay? If you are using a leverage, a 10 to 1, okay, you are maximizing your risk. So instead of 5%, you have to see whether you can use a 1% instead, okay? Because if you're using 10 to 1, your risk is maximized, is multiplied by 10 in that case, okay? So you need to consider the leverage that you are using, okay? So you should be aware of it, that if you're using 10 to 1, you are taking 5% of your account. It's not 5% of your account. It has 50% of your account straight away, okay? So be aware of that, and then so you know exactly, you calculate and make the division, and to know exactly how much you are risking at each time, because a lot of traders will see the account being wiped away, which is a very sad situation. We don't want that. We want to be in the market, because if you cannot trade, that's it. But you want to trade. I think that's correct. Everybody wants to trade. So you must use only 5% of your trading account each time, okay? That's a very important rule. The second thing that I need to mention about the risk control is the stop loss. I use not ordinary stop loss, I use a guaranteed stop loss. And the TSTW 24 recommends strongly to every trader to use a stop loss. whether you are master trader, whether you are professional trader, whether you are amateur trader, whether you are hedge fund manager, whoever you are, you must use a stop loss, okay? Now, if you are TSTW24 trader and you are not using a stop loss, please let me know, and then we stop communicating with you completely, because we do not condone those kind of activity. As a serious trader, as somebody who is willing to follow the professional, you must use the stop loss. Even if you have a triple green signal, which is a high probability trade, you must use a stop loss. I always use stop loss, not only ordinary stop loss, a guaranteed stop loss, because I want to know that if the I know how much risk I'm taking, okay? If the trader is turning against me, I know how much I'm going to lose. So I take the emotion away from the trade. I can walk away from my computer, and I know that everything is perfectly okay. If I come back, everything disappear, I know that, okay, I still got money to trade, and you should be able to gain back your money. So the stop loss, the 5% of your trading account, these are very important tools that you can use in order to control the risk. Another thing that you need to also to pay attention to is the reward risk ratio, okay? Now, before you enter the trade, you ask yourself, is it worth entering this trade? Some of the trades are useless, okay? Which means that the probability of the trade being successful is just not there. Or also the time of the day that you are trading, there's no activity, okay? Especially the Asia session, or when a professional out of the market, you are trading and then there's no movement. Those are the time that the market will do some lot of funny things, okay? And you see that, okay, that is going on, because you must trade with the professional in order to gain a lot in this market, because you want to have volume in the market, huge volume to support the signal that you are taking. If there's no volume, the price not going anywhere, okay? So you must decide when you should recognize the time of the day that you should come. I always trade and respect the opening bell, okay? Now, another thing I need to mention here, now I will make that talk about that another time. So we are talking now about how you locate the trade and the risk reward. Some of the trade you will know clearly, especially the single green and the single red signal, are excellent high probability trade that will give you up to a 3-to-1 risk reward, okay? Reward risk ratio, okay? Excellent time to enter the trade, okay? So you know your signal, you measure the reward, how much you are able to earn. So if you are entering, you are buying at one support level, you must locate the next resistance level, which build the normal place to consider taking the profit. So you calculate how much profit you can make from this support level to the next resistance level. The same thing, if you are selling at a resistance level, you should consider straight away where is the nearest support level. So if the nearest support level is right there in front of you, there's no point to sell. That's what a lot of people are doing this evening. They were buying into a resistance zone, because we were expecting the USD yen to find a resistance in the region of 8300, okay? Now people were buying around the region of 8255. I mean, that's too close, okay? The whole day the USD yen was going up, and people coming too late when the price went all the way to 8275, which is near a resistance level at 83. So do not, when you're going to buy, locate the support level where you are buying, because we always buy at the support level during the uptrend, okay? Do not try to buy during the downtrend. Buy in the uptrend at the support level and consider the next resistance level, because when the price is going up, it's seeking a resistance level, a better resistance level. Till it find a better resistance level, then it will turn around. So you must consider that. Same thing when the price is going down, the price is looking for a better support level. So when you are selling at one resistance level in the downtrend, you consider the next support level. If the support level is too close, there's no point. And also the time of the day you are entering the market, this is about risk management, okay? Now, another thing that I can also talk to you about is the target, okay? Because people enter the trade and they don't know when they're going to come off the trade. They don't know how far the trade is going to go. Now, we will do another video where we will talk about how you can know exactly your target. By using a support and resistance level, you can also locate your target, and so you know exactly now it is time to come out of the trade, okay? Now, people don't know when they should come out of the trade. and stay there. Sometimes they see a winning trade become a losing trade. That's completely wrong. Okay. Another thing also, how you control the risk is the number of trade that you are taking. Sometimes new trader will come into the market, okay, and they will open all sorts of positions, okay, especially those who are trading forex. They are taking a lot of risk because most of the currency pair, the euro GBP, the Australian dollar yen, the Australian dollar US dollar, okay, the New Zealand dollar US dollar, most of this currency move the same direction like euro USD. Now, if you're going to take any trade in those currency pair, the first currency pair you must pay attention to is the euro USD. So you see people taking all sorts of trade in the forex market without paying attention to the euro USD. We know that the USD Canadian or the USD card, which is the US dollar Canadian dollar currency pair, okay. And we know also that sometimes the USD yen also go the opposite direction to the euro USD. So you should know all these things so you know which action to take. That's why I always pay attention to the euro USD because I'm a forex trader, okay, mainly I trade stock also, but when I come into the market, I watch the euro USD before I take any action, okay. So I'm using it as my indicator also. At the same time, I'm trading the euro USD, okay. If you are trading stock also, the same thing you do, watch S&P 500 and make your decision. So do not overtrade. That's another thing to control the risk. Because if you are overtrading, opening 100 trade or whatever, if you trade more than 8 trade per day, that's a lot, okay? Now, I mean, unless you are hedge fund manager, which means you're going to open more positions like this. But you're looking for, if you are looking for the high, okay, the high probability trade, okay, the best reward risk ratio trade, you can't find more than 8 in one day. I mean, you may sometime, but not always, okay? So you minimize the number of trades you are taking. So if you take too many trades, you are increasing also your risk. That's part of it, okay? And also those chances that you're going to go over your 5% limit of your trading account. This is about how you can control the risk in the market, okay? So I think for those tools, you can also the tools that you are using, okay? If you want to fly a plane, okay, you must be trained as a pilot, qualified pilot, and test the equipment, test the machine, everything, before you start going into the air. So when you are coming to trade also, you must test your tool, know that these tools are valid, they can perform, you know the performance of your tool, their capability, the resistance of those tools, how they can perform and deliver the good for you. Okay, so you must have test your tool and know that the tool can perform, and so you can count on your tool and rely on them and understand also your tool and be fluent also in your tool. Another thing I need to mention before the end of this video also is that you must have a plan. The plan will allow you, if things are going the other way, you know straight away and you come out. So you have plan A and plan B. This is how you can control the risk in this market. And I was very impressed by what the email that my friend TSTW24 Traders has sent to me. And that's why I'm doing the video. And I will do more video regarding this risk management. I hope you find this video useful, that you remember to use the stop loss, the most important thing about the stop loss, and the 5% rule of your trading account. Also, another thing I need to mention before the end, the range of the tradable that you are trading, whether you are trading stock or currency, you should know how far that currency can move in one day. The euro USD can move up to 150 point pips per day, okay? So when you want to consider all this, when you're going to swing trade, consider the range of the volatility, the personality of the stock, of the currency or the commodity, whatever you are trading. Every currency, every stock, every tradable have a volatility, a range. Consider also the range of that. I hope this video is useful to you, that you put into practice in order to control the risk and become a better trader. Until the next time, enjoy yourself and be very happy. Thank you.